This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Lockheed P-3 Orion is a four-engine turboprop anti-submarine and maritime surveillance aircraft developed for the United States Navy and introduced in the 1960s. Lockheed based it on the L-188 Electra commercial airliner. The aircraft is easily distinguished from the Electra by its distinctive tail stinger or MAD boom, used for the magnetic detection of submarines over the years. The aircraft has seen numerous design advancements, most notably to its electronics packages. The P-3 Orion is still in use by numerous navies and air forces around the world, primarily for maritime patrol, reconnaissance, anti-surface warfare and anti-submarine warfare. A total of 734 P-3s have been built, and in 2012, it joined the handful of military aircraft including the Boeing B-52 Stratofortress, Boeing KC-135 Stratotanker, Lockheed C-130 Hercules and the Lockheed U-2 that have seen over 50 years of continuous use by the United States military. The U.S. Navy's remaining P-3C aircraft will eventually be replaced by the P-8A Poseidon. Contents 1 Development 11 Origins 12 Further Developments 2 Design 21 Crew Complement 22 Engine Loiter Shutdown 3 Operational History 31 United States 32 in Cuba 33 in Vietnam 34 in Iraq 35 in Afghanistan 351 in Libya 36 Iran 37 Pakistan 38 in Somalia 39 Civilian Uses 4 Variants 5 Operators 51 Military Operators 511 Former 52 Civilian Operators 6 Notable Events, Accidents, and Incidents 7 Specifications P-3C Orion 8 See also 9 References 91 Notes 92 Bibliography 10 External Links Development Origins In August 1957, the U.S. Navy called for replacement proposals for the piston-engined Lockheed P-2V Neptune later redesignated P-2 and Martin P-5M Marlin later redesignated P-5 with a more advanced aircraft to conduct maritime patrol and anti-submarine warfare. Modifying an existing aircraft was expected to save on cost and allow rapid introduction into the fleet. Lockheed suggested a military version of their L-188 Electra, which was still in development and had yet to fly in April 1958. Lockheed won the competition and was awarded an initial research and development contract in May. The first Orion prototype was a converted Lockheed Electra. The prototype YP-3V1, YP-3A, Bureau Number Buno 148276 was modified from the third Electra. Airframe C.N-1003 The first flight of the aircraft's aerodynamic prototype, originally designated YP-3V1, was on 19 August 1958. While based on the same design philosophy as the Lockheed L-188 Electra, the aircraft was structurally different. The aircraft had 7 feet 21. Markings in the early 2000s, the scheme changed to a gloss gray finish with the original full-size color markings, large-size bureau numbers on the vertical stabilizer and squadron designations on the fuselage remained omitted. Further developments P-3 Orions from Japan, Canada, Australia, Republic of Korea and the United States at MCAS Kaneohe Bay during RIMPAC 2010. In 1963, the U.S. Navy Bureau of Weapons BWEPS contracted UNIVAC Defense Systems Division of Sperry Ran to engineer, build and test a digital computer then in its infancy to interface with the many sensors and newly developing display units of the P-3 Orion project. ANU was the engineering system which, after several early trials, produced the engineering prototype, the CP-823, UNIVAC 1830, Serial A1, a new MOD-3 computing system. The CP-823, was delivered to the Naval Air Development Center NADC at Johnsville, Pennsylvania in 1965, and directly led to the production computers later equipped on the P-3C Orion. 3 civilian Electras were lost in fatal accidents between February 1959 and March 1960 following the third crash. The FAA restricted the maximum speed of Electras until the cause could be determined after an extensive investigation. 2 of the crashes in September 1959 and March 1960 were found to be caused by insufficiently strong engine mounts, unable to damp a whirling motion that could affect the outboard engines when the oscillation was transmitted to The wings, a severe vertical vibration escalated until the wings were torn from the aircraft. The company implemented an expensive modification program, labeled the Lockheed Electra Achievement Program or LEAP, in which the engine mounts and wing structures supporting the mounts were strengthened, and some wing skins replaced with thicker material. All the surviving Electras of the 145 built at that time were modified at Lockheed's expense at the factory, the modifications taking 20 days for each aircraft. The changes were incorporated in subsequent aircraft as they were built. Sales of airliners were limited as the technical fix did not completely erase the jinxed reputation. Turboprop-powered aircraft were soon replaced by faster jets in a military role where fuel efficiency was more valued than speed. The Orion has been in service over 50 years after its 1962 introduction, although surpassed in production longevity by the Lockheed C-130 Hercules. 734P-3s were produced through 1990. Lockheed Martin opened a new P-3 wing production line in 2008 as part of its service life extension program ASLEP for delivery in 2010. A complete ASLEP replaces the outer wings, center wing lower section and horizontal stabilizers with newly built parts in the 1990s. During a U.S. Navy attempt to identify a successor aircraft to the P-3, the improved P-7 was selected over a novelized variant of the twin turbofan-powered Boeing 757, but this program was subsequently cancelled in a second program to procure a successor, the Advanced Lockheed Martin Orion 21, another P-3-derived aircraft, lost out to the Boeing P-8 Poseidon, a Boeing 737 variant, which entered service in 2013. Design P-3A, a VP-49 in the original blue-white colors, underside view of a P-3C showing the mad rear boom and external sonobuoy launch tubes, grid of black spots towards the rear. Rolls-Royce Allison T-56A14 engine with Hamilton Standard 54H60-77 propeller. The P-3 has an internal bomb bay under the front fuselage which can house conventional Mark 50 torpedoes or Mark 46 torpedoes and or special nuclear weapons. Additional underwing stations, or pylons, can carry other armament configurations including the AGM-84 Harpoon, AGM-84E SLAM, AGM-84HK Slammer, the AGM-65 Maverick, 127mm 50. Immediately prior to a torpedo or depth bomb attack, due to the sensitivity of the detector, electromagnetic noise can interfere with it, so the detector is placed in P-3's fiberglass tail stinger mad boom. Far from other electronics and ferrous metals on the aircraft, crew complement. The crew complement varies depending on the role being flown, the variant being operated, and the country that is operating the type in U.S. Navy service. The normal crew complement was 12 until it was reduced to its current complement of 11 in the early 2000s. When the in-flight ordnanceman ORD position was eliminated as a cost savings measure and the ORD duties assumed by the in-flight technician. IFT data for U.S. Navy P-3C only officers, 3 naval aviators, patrol plane commander PPC, patrol plane second pilot PP2P, patrol plane third pilot PP3P2, naval flight officers, patrol plane tactical coordinator PPTC or TACO, patrol plane navigator, communicator PPN C or NAVCOM. Note, NAVCOM on P-3C only. USN P-3A and P-3B series had an NFO navigator TACNAV and an enlisted airborne radio operator RO. Enlisted aircrew, 2 enlisted aircrew flight engineers FE-1 and FE-2. 3 enlisted sensor operators radar, MAD, EWOSS-32, acoustic SS-1 and SS-21. Enlisted in-flight technician IFT-1. Enlisted aviation ordnanceman ORD position no longer used on USN crews. Duties assumed by IFT. The senior of either the PPC or TACO will be designated as the aircraft mission commander. MCN engine loiter shutdown. Once on station, one engine is often shut down, usually the number one engine, the left outer engine, to conserve fuel and extend the time aloft and or range. When at low level, it is the primary candidate for loiter shutdown because it has no generator. Eliminating the exhaust from engine 1 also improves visibility from the aft observer station on the port side of the aircraft. On occasion, both outboard engines can be shut down, weight, weather, and fuel permitting. Long deep water, coastal or border patrol missions can last over 10 hours and may include extra crew. The record time aloft for a P-3 is 215 hours, undertaken by the Royal New Zealand Air Force's No. 5 Squadron in 1972. Operational history: United States P-3B AVP-6 near Hawaii, US P-3C Orion AVP-8 changing a tire on a P-3C developed during the Cold War. The P-3's primary mission was to track Soviet Navy ballistic missile and fast attack submarines and to eliminate them in the event of full-scale war at its height. The U.S. Navy's P-3 community consisted of 24 active duty fleet patrol squadrons home-based at air stations in the states of Florida and Hawaii, as well as bases which formerly had P-3 operations in Maryland, Maine, and California. There were also 13 Naval Reserve Patrol squadrons identical to their active duty fleet counterparts, said Reserve Fleet squadrons being based in Florida, Pennsylvania, Maryland, Michigan, Massachusetts, later relocated to Maine, Illinois, Tennessee, Louisiana, California, and Washington. Two Fleet Replacement Squadrons FRS, also called RAG squadrons from the historic Replacement Air Group nomenclature, were located in California and Florida. The since deactivated VP-31 in California provided P-3 training for the Pacific Fleet, while VP-30 in Florida performed the task for the Atlantic Fleet. These squadrons were also augmented by a test and evaluation squadron in Maryland, two additional test and evaluation units that were part of an air development center in Pennsylvania and a test center in California, an oceanographic development squadron in Maryland, and two active duty special projects units in Texas and Hawaii, the latter being slightly smaller than a typical squadron. Reconnaissance missions in international waters led to occasions where Soviet fighters would bump a P-3, either operated by the U.S. Navy or other operators such as the Royal Norwegian Air Force. On 1 April 2001, a mid-air collision between a United States Navy EP-3E Ares II signals surveillance aircraft and a People's Liberation Army Navy J-8II jet fighter interceptor resulted in an international dispute between the U.S. and the People's Republic of China PRC. More than 40 combatant and non-combatant P-3 variants have demonstrated the rugged reliability displayed by the platform flying 12-hour-plus missions. 200. E-2 Hawkeye or an APG-66 radar adapted from the General Dynamics F-16 Fighting Falcon, and for NASA for research and development. The U.S. Navy remains the largest P-3 operator, currently distributed between a single fleet replacement, i.e., training patrol squadron in Florida VP-30, 12 active duty patrol squadrons distributed between bases in Florida, Washington and Hawaii, two Navy Reserve patrol squadrons in Florida and Washington, one active duty special projects patrol squadron VPU-2 in Hawaii, and two active duty test and evaluation squadrons. One additional active duty fleet reconnaissance squadron VQ-1 operates the EP-3 Ares signals intelligence SIGINT variant at Naval Air Station Whidbey Island, Washington. In January 2011, the U.S. Navy revealed that P-3s have been used to hunt down third-generation narco subs. This is significant because as recently as July 2009, fully submersible submarines have been used in smuggling operations in Cuba. Main article: Cuban Missile Crisis. In October 1962, P-3A aircraft flew several blockade patrols in the vicinity of Cuba, having just recently joined the operational fleet earlier that year. This was the first employment of the P-3 in a real-world, near-conflict situation in Vietnam. Main article: Operation Market Time. Beginning in 1964, forward deployed P-3 aircraft began flying a variety of missions under Operation Market Time from bases in the Philippines and Vietnam. The primary focus of these coastal patrols was to stem the supply of materials to the Viet Cong by sea, although several of these missions also became overland feet dry sorties. During one such mission, a small caliber artillery shell passed through a P-3 without rendering it mission incapable. The only confirmed combat loss of a P-3 also occurred during Operation Market Time in April 1968. A U.S. Navy P-3B AVP-26 was downed by anti-aircraft fire in the Gulf of Thailand with the loss of the entire crew 2 months earlier. In February 1968, another one AVP-26, a P-3B aircraft, was operating in the same vicinity when it crashed with the loss of the entire crew, originally attributed to an aircraft mishap at low altitude. Later conjecture is that this aircraft may have also fallen Pentagon victim to AAA fire from the same source as the April incident in Iraq. Main articles: Operation Desert Shield, Gulf War, Desert Storm, and Operation Iraqi Freedom. On 2 August 1990, Iraq invaded Kuwait and was poised to strike Saudi Arabia within 48 hours of the initial invasion. U.S. Navy P-3C aircraft were among the first American forces to arrive in the area. One was a modified platform with a prototype system known as Outlaw Hunter, undergoing trials in the Pacific after being developed by the Navy Space Systems Command. SPAWAR, Outlaw Hunter, was testing a specialized over-the-horizon targeting OTHT system package when it responded within hours of the start of the coalition air campaign. Outlaw Hunter detected a large number of Iraqi patrol boats and naval vessels attempting to move from Basra and Qasr to Iranian waters. Outlaw Hunter vectored in strike elements which attacked the flotilla near Boubiyan Island, destroying 11 vessels and damaging scores more during Desert Shield. A P-3 using infrared imaging detected a ship with Iraqi markings beneath freshly painted bogus Egyptian markings, trying to avoid detection several days before the 7 January 1991 commencement of Operation Desert Storm. A P-3C equipped with an APS-137 inverse synthetic aperture radar ISAR conducted coastal surveillance along Iraq and Kuwait to provide pre-strike reconnaissance on enemy military installations. A total of 55 of the 108 Iraqi vessels destroyed during the conflict were targeted by P-3C aircraft. The P-3 Orion's mission expanded in the late 1990s and early 2000s to include battlespace surveillance both at sea and over land. The long range and long loiter time of the P-3 Orion have proved to be an invaluable asset during Operation Iraqi Freedom and Operation Enduring Freedom. It can instantaneously provide information about the battlespace it can see to ground troops, particularly the U.S. Marines in Afghanistan. Main article: War in Afghanistan 2001-2014. Although the P-3 is a maritime patrol aircraft, armament and sensor upgrades in the Anti-Surface Warfare Improvement Program AIP have made it suitable for sustained combat air support over land since the start of the current war in Afghanistan. U.S. Navy P-3 aircraft have been operating from Kandahar in that role. Royal Australian Air Force AP-3C Orions operated out of Minhad Air Base in the UAE from 2003 until their withdrawal in November 2012. During the period 2008 to 2012, the AP-3C Orions conducted overland intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance tasks in support of coalition troops throughout Afghanistan. Recently, the United States Geological Survey used the Orion to survey parts of southern and eastern Afghanistan for lithium, copper, and other mineral deposits in Libya. Main article: 2011 Libyan Civil War. Several U.S. Navy P-3C Orions, and two Canadian CP-140 Auroras, a variant of the Orion, have participated in maritime surveillance missions over Libyan waters in the framework of enforcement of the 2011 no-fly zone over Libya. A U.S. Navy P-3C Orion supporting Operation Odyssey Dawn engaged the Libyan Coast Guard vessel Vittoria on 28 March 2011 after the vessel and two smaller craft fired on merchant ships in the port of Misrata, Libya. The Orion fired AGM-65 Maverick missiles on Vittoria, which was subsequently beached. Iran. A U.S. Navy F-14 Tomcat escorts an Iranian P-3F Orion over the Indian Ocean. 1981 Lockheed produced the P-3F variant of the P-3 Orion for Iran. Six examples were delivered to the former Imperial Iranian Air Force IIAF in 1975 and 1976 following the Iranian Revolution. In 1979, the Orions continued in service, after the IIAF was renamed the Islamic Republic of Iran Air Force IRIAF. They were used in the tanker war phase of the Iran-Iraq War and were operated by one of the most successful squadrons of the IRIAF during that conflict. A total of four P-3Fs remain in service. Pakistan. A Pakistan Navy P-3C Orion in Quetta. In October 2010, three P-3C Orions, delivered to the Pakistan Navy in 1996 and 1997, were operated extensively during the Kargil conflict after the crash of one. The type was grounded due to the loss of an entire crew. Nonetheless, the aircraft were maintained in an armed state and airworthy condition throughout the escalation period of 2001 and 2002. In 2007, they were used by the Navy to conduct signals intelligence, airborne and bombing operations in a SWAT offensive, and Operation Ra-e-Nijat precision and strategic bombing missions were carried out by the Orions, and in 2007, intelligence management operations were conducted against Taliban and Al-Qaeda operatives. On 22 May 2011, two out of the four Pakistani P-3Cs were destroyed in an attack on PNS Marin, a Pakistani naval station in Karachi. The Pakistani fleet had been readily used in overland counter-insurgency operations in June 2011. The U.S. agreed to replace the destroyed aircraft with two new ones, with delivery to follow later in February 2012. The U.S. delivered two additional P-3C Orion aircraft to the Pakistan Navy in Somalia. A U.S. Navy P-3C Orion monitoring the hijacking of MV Maersk Alabama, 2009 main article, piracy in Somalia. The Spanish Air Force deployed P-3s to assist the international effort against piracy in Somalia on 29 October 2008. A Spanish P-3 aircraft patrolling the coast of Somalia reacted to a distress call from an oil tanker in the Gulf of Aden to deter the pirates. The aircraft flew over the pirates three times as they attempted to board the tanker, dropping a smoke bomb on each pass. After the third pass, the attacking pirate boats broke off their attack later. On 29 March 2009, the same P-3 pursued the assailants of the German Navy tanker Spessart A-1442, resulting in the capture of the pirates in April 2011. The Portuguese Air Force also contributed to Operation Ocean Shield by sending a P-3C, which had early success when on its fifth mission detected a pirate whaler with two attack skiffs. Since 2009, the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force has deployed P-3s to Djibouti for anti-piracy patrols. From 2011, from its own base, civilian uses Aero Union P-3A Orion taking off from Fox Field, Lancaster, California, to fight the North Fire. Several P-3 aircraft have been N-registered and are operated by civilian agencies. The U.S. Customs and Border Protection has a number of P-3A and P-3B aircraft that are used for aircraft intercept and maritime patrol. NOAA operates two WP-3D variants specially modified for hurricane research. One P-3B N426NA is used by National Aeronautics and Space Administration NASA as an Earth Science Research Platform, primarily for the NASA Science Mission Directorate's Airborne Science Program. It is based at Goddard Space Flight Center's Wallops Flight Facility, Virginia. Aero Union, Inc. operated 8X USN P-3A aircraft configured as air tankers, which were leased to the U.S. Forest Service, the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection, and other agencies for firefighting use. Several of these aircraft were involved in the U.S. Forest Service airtanker scandal but have not been involved in any catastrophic aircraft mishaps. Aero Union has since gone bankrupt, and their P-3s have been put up for auction. Variants main article, P-3 Orion variants. Over the years, numerous variants of the P-3 have been created. A few notable examples are WP-3D, two P-3C aircraft as modified on the production line for NOAA weather research, including hurricane hunting EP-3E Ares, 10 P-3A and two EP-3B aircraft converted into ELINT aircraft EP-3E Ares 2, 12 P-3C aircraft converted into ELINT aircraft AP-3C, Royal Australian Air Force P-3 CW aircraft, which have been extensively upgraded by L3 Communications with new mission systems, including an ELTASAR, ISAR radar and a GD Canada acoustic processor system CP-140 Aurora, long-range maritime reconnaissance, anti-submarine warfare aircraft for the Canadian Forces based on the P-3C Orion airframe, but mounts the more advanced electronics suite of the Lockheed S-3 Viking, 18-built CP-140A Arcturus, 3 P-3s without ASW equipment for Canadian Aurora crew training and various coastal patrol missions. P-7 proposed new build and improved variant as a P-3 Orion replacement, later cancelled. Orion 21 proposed new build and improved variant as a P-3 Orion replacement, lost to the Boeing P-8 Poseidon. P-3K-2, Royal New Zealand Air Force P-3K-2 aircraft, which have been fully upgraded with totally new mission systems by L-3 Mission Integration Division, Greenville, Texas. The flight deck now has glass instrumentation and navigation computer automation. The tactical rail-to-rail has been completely refitted with modern sensors, communication and data management systems. Operators map with P-3 operators in red, former operators in light red. Argentine Navy P-3B P-3C, 11 Squadron RAAF, in 1990 Canadian CP-140 Aurora, in June 2007 P-3C of the German Navy AP-3P Orion S, N-14802 at Faro Airport in 1994 Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force P-3C NOAA WP-3D Hurricane Hunters U.S. Department of Homeland Security P-3AEW German Navy, 8 P-3C Cup X Royal Netherlands Navy, based at NAS Nordholz, Marinefliegergeschwader 3 Graf Zeppelin. Mission system upgrades by L3 Communications Canada and now designated as P-3K2 due to be replaced in 2025 with equivalent level of capability, either manned or unmanned. Electronics, including new magnetic anomaly detectors, electro-optical sensors, surveillance equipment and a self-protection suite. The Navy's impetus stems from a 2010 experience in which ROC forces detected only 28% of North Korean submarines involved in exercises. COAS to collect SIGINT and air samples when the project was terminated in January 1967, all three Black P-3As were flown to NAS Alameda, CA, for long-term storage in September 1967, Lockheed at Burbank, converted two of the three aircraft 149,669 and 149,678 into the only two EP-3B examples in existence in the world, while the third aircraft 149,673 was converted by Lockheed in 1969-1970 to serve as a development aircraft for various electronic programs. The two EP-3Bs known as BAT-RAC, owing to their short period of service with Taiwan's Black Bat Squadron, were issued to U.S. Navy's VQ-1 Squadron in 1969 and deployed to Da Nang, Vietnam later. The two EP-3Bs were converted to EP-3E Ares, along with seven EP-3 as the two EP-3S retired in the 1980s. When replaced by 12 EP-3E Ares II versions Republic of China Navy 12 P-3Cs ordered, with deliveries starting in 2012, with three spare airframes that might be converting to EP-3E standard, based in south part of the island and offshore island in May 2014 Lockheed Martin were awarded a contract to upgrade and overhaul all 12 P-3Cs for completion by August 2015. National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Administration NOAA, two WP-3Ds flown by NOAA Commissioned Corps officers, based at MacDill AFB, Florida. Former Office of Air and Marine 8 P-3LRTs Long Range Tracker. Former USN aircraft also based at NAS Corpus Christi, Texas and Cecil Field, Jacksonville, Florida. Normally operate in tandem with P-3AEW aircraft. Aero Union, 8X USN P-3A, aircraft based at Chico Municipal Airport in Chico, California and converted into aerial firefighting platforms. Notable events, accidents, and incidents. 30 January 1963, United States Navy P-3A Buno 149,762 was lost at sea in the Atlantic Ocean, 14 crew killed. 4 July 1966, Lockheed P-3A Orion, Buno 152,172, construction number 185-5142, assigned to VP-19, radio call sign Papa Echo 05 PE-05, crashed 7 miles 11. To break the Soviet Il-18's May 1968 record of 452 miles per hour, the 26th of May 1972, USN P-3A Buno 152,155 disappeared over the Pacific Ocean on a routine training mission after departing NAS Moffett Field, California, with the loss of eight crew members. The 3rd of June 1972, while attempting to fly through the Straits of Gibraltar, en route from Naval Station Rota, Spain to Naval Air Station Sigonella, Sicily, a U.S. Navy P-3A VP-44 hit a mountain in Morocco, resulting in the death of all 14 crew on board the aircraft. 12 April 1973, a United States Navy P-3C Buno 157,332 operating from NAS Moffett Field, California collided with a Convair CV-990N711NA operated by NASA during approach to runway 32R. The aircraft crashed on the Sunnyvale Municipal Golf Course, 05 miles 080. The 22nd of September 1978, USNP 3B Buno 152,757 from VP-8 disintegrated over Poland, Maine on the 22nd of September 1978 and over-pressurized fuel tank caused the port wing to separate at the outboard engine. The detached wing sheared off part of the tail, and aerodynamic forces caused the remaining engines and starboard wing to detach from the fuselage. Debris rained down near the south end of Trip Pond shortly after 12 o'clock. There were no survivors from the plane's 8-man crew. The 26th of October 1978, USNP 3C Buno 159,892 call sign coded AF-586 from VP-9 operating from Nas Adak ditched at sea after an engine fire caused by a propeller malfunction. 10 of the 15-man crew were rescued by a Soviet trawler. The 27th of June 1979, P-3B Buno 154,596 from VP-22 operating from Nas Kubi Point, Philippines, had a propeller overspeed shortly after departure. The number 4 propeller then departed the aircraft, striking the number 3 with a subsequent fire on that engine while attempting an overweight landing with two engines out. The aircraft stalled, rolled inverted, and crashed in Subic Bay just past Grande Island. 4 crew and 1 passenger were killed in the crash. The 17th of April 1980, USNP 3C Buno 158,213 from VP-50 while flying for a parachuting exhibition in Fiji, struck overhead tram wires and crashed, killing all 6 crew on board. The 17th of May 1983, USNP 3B Buno 152,733 tail coded YB-07 from VP-1 inadvertently landed gear up during a routine dedicated field work DFW pilot training flight at Nas Barbers Point. No crew were injured, but the aircraft was a total loss. The 16th of June 1983, USNP 3B Buno 152,720 tail coded YB-06 from VP-1 at Nas Barbers Point crashed into a mountain top in fog and low clouds on the Nepali coast between the Hanapu and Kalalau valleys in Kauai, Hawaii shortly after 0400 hours, killing all 14 on board. The 13th of September 1987, a Royal Norwegian Air Force P-3B tail number 602, is hit from below by a Russian Air Force Suhoi Su-27 of the 941st IAPVPVO. The Su-27 flew below the P-3's starboard side, then accelerated and pulled up, clipping the number 4 engine's propellers. The propeller shrapnel hit the Orion's fuselage and caused a decompression. There were no injuries and both aircraft returned safely to base. The 25th of September 1990, the first production model P-3C Update 3, Buno 161,762, assigned to VP-31 at Nas Moffett Field, impacted the runway at an excessive rate of descent while conducting at dedicated field work sortie at Naval Auxiliary Landing Field Crow's Landing. Both main landing gear failed and the aircraft slid down the runway. Some crewmembers sustained minor injuries, but there were no fatalities. The aircraft was a total loss. The 21st of March 1991, while on a training mission west of San Diego, California, two U.S. Navy P-3C Orions, Bunos 158,930 and 159,325 assigned to VP-50 based at Nas Moffett Field collided in mid-air, killing all 27 crew on board both aircraft. The 26th of April 1991, AP-3C, tail number A9-754 of the Royal Australian Air Force, lost a wing leading edge and crashed into shallow water in the Cocos Island. One crewman was killed. Aircraft was cut up and used as an artificial reef. The head investigator of this incident was RAAF FLTLT Richard Hall. The 25th of March 1995, USNP 3C Buno 158,217 assigned to VP-47 was returning from a training mission in the North Arabian Sea when it suffered catastrophic engine failure of the number 4 engine. The aircraft ditched at sea 2 miles 32. The 15th of February 2014, 3 U.S. Navy P-3C Orions were crushed beyond repair when their hangar, at NAF Atsugi, Japan was destroyed due to a massive snow storm. Specifications: P-3C Orion P-3 aircraft of the Royal New Zealand Air Force, Royal Australian Air Force, and the United States Navy with RAAF Dassault Mirage 3. General characteristics: crew, 11 length, 116 feet 10 in 356 meters wingspan, 99 feet 8 8 in 304 meters height, 38 feet 8 in 118 meters wing area, 1,300 square feet, 1,208 square meters airfoil, NACA0014-110 route, NACA0012-110 tip empty weight, 77,200 pounds, 35,000 kilograms useful load, 57,800 pounds, 26,400 kilograms loaded weight, 135,000 pounds, 61,400 kilograms max takeoff weight, 142,000 pounds, 64,400 kilograms powerplant, 4x Allison T56A14 turboprop, 4,600 SHP, 3,700 kilowatts each. Propellers, 4-bladed Hamilton standard propeller, 1 per engine propeller diameter, 13 feet 6 in 411 m performance maximum speed, 411 kN 750 km per hour cruise speed, 328 kN 610 km per hour range, 2380 nmi radius, 4400 km combat radius, 1346 nmi 2490 km 3 hours on station at 1,500 feet ferry range, 4,830 nmi 8,944 km endurance, 16 hours service ceiling, 28,300 feet 8,625 meters rate of climb, 3,140 feet per minute 16 meters per second wing loading, 107 pounds per square foot 530 kilograms per square meter power, mass, 0136 horsepower per pound at max gross 023. Rockets, none missiles, air-to-surface missile, AGM-65 Maverick, AGM-84 Harpoon, AGM-84 standoff land attack missile SLAM-ER bombs, depth charges, MK-101 Lulu nuclear depth bomb, MK-20 Rockai, MK-80 series MK-82, MK-83, MK-84 general-purpose bombs, B-57 nuclear bomb U.S. service only, retired 1993 other, MK-44 mostly retired from service, MK-46 MK-50, MK-54 or MU-90 impact torpedoes MK-25 MK-39, MK-55 MK-56, MK-60 Captor or MK-65 Quickstrike Naval Mine Stonefish Naval Mine in Australian service active and passive sonobuoys avionics radar, Raytheon and APS-115 Maritime Surveillance Radar, and APS-137 DV-5 Inverse Synthetic Aperture Search Radar IFF, APX-72, APX-76, APX-118 123rds Interrogation Friend or Foe IFF EO, IR, ASX-4 Advanced Imaging Multispectral Sensor AIMS, ASX-6 Multi-Mode Imaging System MMIS. ESM, ALR-66 Radar Warning Receiver, ALR-95V2 Specific Emitter Identification, Threat Warning Hazeltine Corporation and ARR-78V Sonobuoy Receiving System Fighting Electronics Inc. and ARR-72 Sonobuoy Receiver IBM Proteus UYS-1 Acoustic Processor AQA-7 Directional Acoustic Frequency Analysis and Recording Sonobuoy Indicators AQH-4V Sonar Tape Recorder ASQ-8 81 Magnetic Anomaly Detector MAD ASA 65 Magnetic Compensator Lockheed Martin and ALQ-78V Electronic Surveillance Receiver See also United States Navy Portal Aviation Portal Lockheed P-2 Neptune Martin P-5 Marlin Related Development Lockheed CP-140 Aurora Lockheed EP-3 Lockheed L-188 Electra Lockheed P-7 Lockheed WP-3D Orion Aircraft of Comparable Role, Configuration and Era Avro Shackleton Boeing P-8 Poseidon Bombardier Aerospace DHC-8 MPA D-8 Brigitte Atlantique Canadair CP-107 Argus CASA CN-235 MPA CASA C-295 MPA EADS HC-144 Ocean Sentry Hawker Siddeley Nimrod Ilyushin IL-38 Kawasaki P-1 Shin Miwa PS-1 Related Lists List of Lockheed P-3 Orion variants. List of military aircraft of the United States. List of active United States military aircraft. List of Lockheed Aircraft. References. Notes. Caret A B C D E F G H I J K L M N O P Q R S T P 3 C Orion Long Range ASW Aircraft. Navy Mil. The 18th of February 2009. Retrieved. The 14th of July 2010. Caret A B Lockheed Martin P 3 Orion Aeroflight Kook. The 31st of July 2010. Retrieved. The 16th of November 2010 Caret P3 production. P3 Orion NL retrieved the 7th of June 2011 Caret ABCD P3 history Global Security Org retrieved the 14th of July 2010 Caret Reed 1998 Caret second VP9 Dictionary of American Naval Aviation Squadrons volume 2 P74 retrieved the 7th of July 2012 Caret Thomas Todd J First Digital Airborne Computing System UNIVAC 1830, CP-823, U-Serial A New Mod 3, Engineering Prototype Lockheed P-3 Orion P-3 Orion Top Secret Com, 2010 Retrieved, 9 December 2010 Caret A.B. Serling, Robert J., Loud and Clear, Dell, 1970 Caret Lessons of a Turboprop Inquest Flight 17 February 1961 P-225 Caret Murphy, Pat, Fighting Fire Like a Regular Military Ground, Air War, One-Time Jinxed Airliner Now a Superstar Fire Bomber Mid Expresscom, 2010 Retrieved, 16 November 2010 Caret P-3 Orion Overview Federation of American Scientists FAS Retrieved, 25 January 2011 Caret Lockheed Martin Awarded Contract to Build Outer Wingsets for the U.S. Navy's P-3 Orion Fleet DeagleCom, 4 September 2008 Caret P-3C HistoryNavyMil Retrieved, 14 July 2010 Caret Air Anti-Submarine Warfare FASORG Retrieved the 14th of July 2010 Caret Born to Fly by Lieutenant Shane Osborne Navy Lieutenant Shane Osborne's Tale of Danger and Survival ABC NewsGocom the 30th of September 2004 retrieved the 28th of July 2010 Caret P-3 Subhunters Using ASW Gear to Find Narco Subs DefenseTechHorg, the 14th of January 2011 Retrieved, the 25th of January 2011 Caret Page, Lewis First True Submarine Captured from American Drug Smugglers. The Register, the 6th of July 2010 Retrieved, the 25th of January 2011 Caret VP-26 Memorial, VP-26 Crew, In Memoriam, VP-26 Crew VP NaviOrg Retrieved, the 14th of July 2010 Caret Reed 1998, PP-42-49 Caret A.B. Chudy, Jason P-3C Anti-Surface Warfare Improvement Program P-3C AIP Lockheed MartinCom Retrieved, the 14th of July 2010 Caret Chudy Jason P-3C Anti-Surface Warfare Improvement Program P-3C AIP MilitaryCom Retrieved, 14 July 2010 Caret Defense Ministers